Hey guys, Greg from Carid.com, and today we are going to do a little bit of work on this Nissan Frontier behind me. So if you own a Frontier, Xterra, or Pathfinder with the 4.0 V6, and it's about time to change some spark plugs on it, tune into this video because I'm going to show you every single step of what you need to do to get the job done yourself in your own garage. So before you get started taking anything apart on your engine, you need to make sure you have the right tools. Now the good thing is, with this job, you only need basic hand tools. Now by basic hand tools, I mean a socket set, a couple of plug sockets, and some extensions, and you can easily get this job done. All right, so with the tools portion covered, let's talk about the parts that you're gonna need to perform this job. Now, like I said earlier, if you own a Frontier, Xterra, or Pathfinder from 2005 to 2016 with the 4-liter V6, these are the parts you're gonna need. Now, what I have with me today are the original OE NGK laser iridium spark plugs. Now, why am I going with the OE? Well, unless you're actually building a motor for performance applications, I highly suggest just sticking with the original plug that came with the car. Now sure, there may be less expensive spark plugs out there that will fit your application, but sometimes they may not last and it may run a little bit weird than what it did when it was brand new. If these are good enough to last 100,000 miles beforehand, they're good enough to last another 100,000 miles. That's why I always suggest sticking with the OE. Now the part number on these particular plugs is going to be 93759. That's the exact part number that you need if you're performing this job on your Nissan. Now on the Nissan 4-liter V6, unfortunately, the spark plugs on one side of the engine are going to be hidden under the intake manifold. So you're going to have to remove that to access those plugs. Now once you remove it, you really should replace the intake gaskets. Now this kit is one that we got from Felpro, and it actually includes both the upper and lower intake gaskets. Now we're not going to use the lower today because we're only going to be pulling the upper, but it is going to come as a full kit. Now that part number from Felpro is going to be MS96454-2. So once again, if you own any of these Nissans, Frontier, Xterra, or Pathfinder from 05 to 16, these are the parts you're gonna need to get this job done. Now that we know everything that we need, let's go ahead and get started. All right guys, so as you can see, this thing is clearly a daily driver. This is no pristine engine bay here. This thing is used to tow, haul, and it has spent a little bit of time off-road, so we wanna make sure it's maintained, and that's exactly why we're doing the spark plug change today. Now to get started, I gotta get a lot out of the way first before we can even get this intake manifold off, which is going to include this engine cover here so we can have access to the bolts, the intake tube running from the air filter, as well as the throttle body. And there's a couple series of brackets lower on this side of the intake manifold, as well as one on the back of the engine here so we can get the wiring harness out of the way. So I'm gonna take you step by step on getting all of that prepped to make sure we can get this manifold off. Next, we gotta get this second cover off, which is actually connected to the intake tube, so this is gonna come off as one assembly. Once again, two 10 millimeter bolts, hold it in place. So those can come out. And then I'm going ahead and loosen the hose clamps for the intake tube. Now we can just work this out nice and easy. You don't have to take off the whole air box. Now before you take this piece off, there is a hose for the PCV system connected to it. Take a pair of pliers, squeeze the clamp, move it back, and we can just slowly work that hose off. Beautiful. Now with that disconnected, we can remove the entire intake tube. Now this is a tip for all of you Nissan owners doing this job. Now this throttle body has to be removed to get the intake manifold off. However, I don't want to disconnect the actual connector. And the reason for that is, if you disconnect that connector, you have to relearn the throttle body. This is an electronic drive-by-wire throttle body. I mean, there's no cable or anything else. It's all electrical inputs from an actual ECU. Now, since I don't want to go ahead and have to relearn it, because if you have a Nissan tool, it's something easy to do. But if you're doing this at home in your own garage, you have to go through a crazy sequence of turning the key on and off, hitting the gas pedal at certain intervals. And honestly, I've done it before. It's taken me anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes to get it right just once. So save yourself the headache, remove the throttle body, and within that new Felpro kit, you're gonna have a new throttle body gasket anyway, so all is gonna be fine.
Then you're gonna need a 5mm Allen key socket, and we'll crack all these guys loose. Take that final bolt out, and we're just simply gonna let this throttle body just rest out of the way. All right guys, so at this point, I'm gonna work my way around the manifold to get everything disconnected that needs to be disconnected to actually pull the upper intake off the top of the motor. That's gonna include a couple evap lines on the back of the intake here, on top, and a couple over there. One of the electrical connectors for the evap purge line, and a couple other odds and ends. And then the next thing that we wanna tackle is getting this main wiring harness out of the way. There's a bracket in the back that we'll tackle next. Pretty much what we're doing though is we're getting everything out of the way so we can lift this entire intake up and off the motor and have a nice, smooth and easy transition to the spark plugs. Now we're going to remove the connector for the evap purge valve. And once that's done, there is an additional bracket that has to be, there's two bolts back here that need to get unbolted that actually holds down the intake. And then we'll work our way to the back here, again to this main wiring harness that we need to get out of the way. All right, so now we're gonna deal with this wiring harness on the back of the motor. Now all you have to do is just squeeze these little trim clips and push it actually out of the bracket that it's held in, and just push it out of the way for when we take the intake off. Now there's also a connector over here. Remove that from the bracket, like so. So when we lift the intake out, we'll have that out of the way. Now I also noticed there is one more vacuum hose on the back of the intake, and that's located right here. Now most likely what I'll do is I'll get the intake loose, move it forward a little bit so I have better access to this clamp, and then just take it off while I'm moving the intake. But now, we need to make sure we have access to all the bolts for the upper intake manifold. So we're gonna go ahead and take care of that now, start cracking those loose so we can lift this thing up. It's actually covering up the intake bolts that I need to remove. So we'll just loosen this one bolt and we'll just move this out of the way for the meantime so we can access all of the intake bolts that we need to get to. All right guys, so we're at the point we're ready to remove our intake manifold, but if you haven't noticed, all these bolts that hold on the intake look a little crusty. So do yourself a favor, get some penetrating oil, spray each and every one of these to try to prevent any issues when taking them out. All right guys, so after you give everything a good soak with penetrating oil, you can come through and take out all six upper intake manifold bolts. So all the bolts are disconnected from the upper intake. As you can see, it's loose. So we're gonna gently lift this up. Now, if you guys remember, I mentioned a vacuum hose in the back that was a little bit difficult to get to. Now that I have the intake up and out, I take my pliers, loosen this clamp. All right, guys, upper intake manifold is off and removed from our Nissan Frontier. And as you can see now, this was what was before hidden. All the spark plugs were hidden under the intake manifold before. Now we have clear and easy access to all the coils and plugs on this side of the engine. Now we can simply proceed with our standard plug change. So what I'm going to do is start loosening every coil individually, lifting them out just a little bit, disconnecting the coil, taking the coil all the way out, and then replacing the plugs. Once we get the plugs out, we're also gonna take a look at their condition to make sure this Nissan's running smoothly. Coil comes out, gives me room to disconnect the connector for the coil. I can take the whole thing out. Now, it's always a nice idea, just take a look at your coils, make sure there's no cracks in the boots themselves, because that can cause arcing. And that can cause things to run a little rough. So this one looks pretty good. Ready to take the plug out next. Now, before we even start, I wanna mention one thing. Pneumatic electrical tools, all great things. Do not use them to uninstall and install new spark plugs. There is just simply too much at risk. You over-tighten them, you break a spark plug in the head, or even taking it out of the motor, you could still possibly break a spark plug in the head. Take your time, just use good old-fashioned hand tools. All right, so plugs are out. And this is a really good time to check the condition of your plugs. And by doing so, you can get a really good idea on how the engine's running and if you possibly have other issues. Now, what you want to see is exactly what we see here. You see kind of like a brownish caramel color along the entire plug. That's going to be a condition of simple, normal burning and operating. So it's not too rich, it's not too lean. Now, if you take your plug out and it is just covered in black soot, your engine's definitely running too rich. And on the opposite spectrum, if this thing is strike white, your engine's running way too lean. That means not enough fuel. Here, we're looking really, really good. There's no oil, there's no fuel residue. This cylinder looks great. All right, guys, first spark plug, brand new spark plug going back into our engine. Now, all these plugs are going to be pre-gapped from the factory, meaning NGK does this already in terms of setting the gap for the electrode on the plug. Now, you can certainly go ahead and double check that before you put the plug in if you really want to, but in this day and age, the way these spark plugs are manufactured, it's really not necessary. But if you want to really, really make sure, you can certainly check that. At this point, we'll thread these back into the cylinder. And then once it's tight, just give it about a quarter turn until it's snug. And that's it. Do not over tighten these things. You do not need to go crazy and really crank these things down. You just want to make sure you feel that lock washer lock, and that's it. Don't go crazy. Trust me. New plugs back in. Now I'm going to get our ignition coil back into the cylinder. I always like to make sure that the coil always bolts back to the exact same cylinder it came out of. So that's exactly why I'm just doing these all one at a time and I'm not mixing up the coils into other cylinders. So we'll just go ahead and move on to the second one. Same process as before. Pull the coil out, disconnect our connector, and get the plug out. Now each time, no matter what cylinder it is, I'm always going to go ahead and check the condition of the spark plugs, because just because one cylinder is okay doesn't mean that they all are. So with each and every cylinder that I replace the plugs, we'll check the condition, make sure all is operating normally, and hopefully we don't find the issues. And that's it. We're essentially going to repeat this exact same process for every single spark plug or the remaining four spark plugs that we're going to change on this motor. I'm going to get all of that done, checking the condition of each plug for each cylinder, and we're ready to soon hopefully put back on the intake manifold. All right, guys, we're moving right along with the tune-up on our Frontier. If you've noticed, I have the upper intake manifold now on our bench because it's time to change the gaskets before we put this back on. So we're going to start by flipping this over, obviously, to get access to our gaskets. And you can see here that they're pretty basic. They're simply these rubber O-rings that are going to sit inside a recess inside the lower intake manifold, and they provide you with this little tab on the outside. So all we have to do is grab this tab, lift it up, and we can pull the gasket right out and then replace them. So I'm gonna do that with all the gaskets that we have here, as well as our throttle body gasket. And once that's all prepped and ready to go, we're gonna get it back on our truck and finish up this job. All right, guys, so it's that easy. We have all of our new intake gaskets in on our intake manifold. I'm gonna take this, get it installed and bolted down back in the truck, essentially repeating the exact same process that we did with the disassembly. And I'm gonna wait till this is mounted and then I'll replace our throttle body gasket to finish things up. All right, guys, so there's two factory studs on the lower intake that you're gonna use to line this up on. It's essentially dowels, just so you can line up the manifold so it doesn't shift around while you tighten it down. Okay. All right, guys, so like I said before, we're simply repeating the process that we did to remove the upper intake manifold. So we're putting those six bolts that we removed back in, and we are going to strategically go through and torque them down. When you do that, you want to make sure you just tighten all the bolts in a crisscross pattern. That way you just make sure that the intake is going to sit flush on the lower and that you don't have any manifold or vacuum leaks. Crisscross pattern, nice and easy. First snug them down, and then you can go back in and tighten them a little bit more. Thank you. good. That's good. This is another scenario. You do not have to over tighten these things. This is a plastic manifold. Just make sure they're good and snug. All right, guys, now with the intake bolted on and snugged up, we're gonna get all those other hoses and accessories that we had to unbolt back on, including our throttle body and our new throttle body gasket. So I'm gonna take you through all that, and before you know it, we're gonna fire this thing up, make sure she runs good. And now, guys, honestly, it's a lot of the hoses that we initially took off that have to go back on. Throttle body gasket, one of the last steps. Same as the other intake gaskets, pull it out, line up the tab. And just use your fingers and work it around into the channel. All right, guys, the new gasket in place. We can hold up our throttle body. Get our Allen bolts back in. We'll get this all snugged up. And we are almost on the home stretch to getting this job done. All right, guys, home stretch. Intake tube is going back on. Just takes a little bit of finessing. And there we go. So now we just have to tighten up all these hose clamps, as well as the two bolts that hold that down. We can put our PCV hose back in. Almost there. All right, guys, last piece of the puzzle. Just double checking we have all our hoses connected. Everything looks good. So we're gonna get our cover back on. Two last bolts, and then we can fire this thing up. All right, guys, everything's back together. We don't have any spare parts, so let's fire it up. All right, guys, well, that's it. That's how easy it is to change a set of spark plugs on a 2011 Nissan Frontier. So, get out there, start working in your garage, and start doing this stuff yourself. You're not only gonna save money, you're gonna start having fun and working on your car. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for all of our product reviews and DIY videos. And I'm Greg from Carid.com, and I'll see you guys next time.